Hi. So I'm in the river today on a very cold winter's day because I thought it might be nice to talk for a couple of minutes about chalk streams. So just down here, we've got the Wallop Brook, which goes down into the Test, which is one of our big chalk rivers. So why are chalk rivers so special? Well, there are only about 200 worldwide, and we've got about 85% of those here in the UK. So we really do need to look after them. Now, they're really special because underneath here is a chalk aquifer. So chalk is very permeable and it acts like a giant sponge and it soaks up and traps that water. And then that water comes out, is filtered out through the chalk and comes out in springs and forms these lovely chalk rivers. So the water, you can see, is really, really clear. So it's lovely, clear, mineral-rich water, slightly alkaline, and it's an absolutely brilliant habitat for a whole range of different creatures. The key thing really, I suppose, is that it stays at the same temperature all year round. So it comes out of those springs at around about 11 degrees all year round. And that lovely constant cool temperature also means that the water is high in oxygen. And that makes it ideal for a whole range of species. So you'll see that we've got watercress starting to come up here. We've got a rather poisonous plant, a hemlock water dropwort, coming up here as well. But you'll see these lovely clean gravels, and they provide a fabulous habitat for the brown trout. So we have all of these plants growing here on these gravels, and you'll find creatures like the brown trout are able to spawn on these gravels simply because they are lovely, clear, clean, as I said, high in oxygen, constant temperature, and also quite constant flow because of it being fed through that aquifer. So it's an ideal habitat for such a range of species. Right, so what I'm going to do is take a kick sample, which is how we survey our rivers, and then I can show you what lives in here. So I'm stepping in nice and carefully. I've got my net, which I'm going to put just a little bit downstream of me on the ground. And what I'm going to do is just gently kick the gravels. And the idea is that anything that's living underneath those stones and rocks will be washed into my net. And we will be able to place this into the white tray, and then we'll be able to have a look and see what you'll find in a chalk river. So I've just come in from doing a stream dip over in my local stream across the road, which is a lovely chalk stream, the Wallop Brook. It got very, very windy outside, so I thought I'd bring the tray in here to have a look and see what we found. Now, although it's only just February, you can see that this tray is absolutely full of life. So there's a wide range of freshwater invertebrates in here, some of which are quite characteristic of chalk streams. So I put one or two of the slightly more interesting creatures into this smaller tray here for us to have a little look at. So I have a plastic spoon here, so we can have a quick look at one or two of these creatures. So this one here is the mayfly, which most people have heard of. This one on my spoon right now. So this is the burrowing mayfly, Ephemera danica, and it's got a fascinating life cycle. It lives in the water for up to 2 years as a nymph. And then it will come out of the water and shed its skin. And initially it will become a sub-adult. And that's unique in the insect world. So in that stage, it needs to sit on a leaf near to the water and dry out and shed its skin another time to become the full adult. And the full adult only lives for a day. So they don't have even a mouth because they don't need to feed. All they're doing is mating and laying their eggs on the water, and then they will die. So fascinating, the larval stage in the water for a couple of years, but the adult stage just has one day to lay its eggs. So a really interesting creature and very, very characteristic of chalk streams. And those particular larger mayflies all tend to hatch around about the end of May, beginning of June, on a nice warm, still evening. And if you do catch that, it's quite a spectacle with them all raising up out of the water, rising up out of the water at once. There are other species of mayfly which will come out of the water at different times of the year. Those ones tend to be a little bit smaller. Now, what else have we got in here? We've also got some caddisfly. So caddisfly larvae. So these creatures here, these are cased caddisfly, and they will use the gravel, which you can see on the stream bed, to build a case for themselves. They use a sort of sticky salivary substance to stick these stones together to make a tube, and they will live inside. And it provides really great protection and very, very good camouflage. Now, different species of caddisfly will build this in slightly different ways, using different materials. Some will use plant materials and bits of wood. Some will stick the stones together in a beautiful, careful mosaic. Others will stick very big stones together in what seems like a bit of a random pattern. It's a really, really fascinating creature. And the adult stage of the caddisfly looks a little bit like a moth, but again, it spends its time flying on land, so not in the water, as the larval stage does. So we've got caddisfly in there, we've got the mayfly nymphs in there, we've also got some freshwater shrimps whizzing around in here, and there should be several other species in here if we have a closer look. So this is the small tray where I put one or two creatures so we can have a closer look. So what I'll do is zoom in so we can have a little look at some of these. So there are a pair of freshwater shrimps, a male and a female, just there together. And then next to those you can see the mayfly nymph, which we were talking about. There it is there. So if you look closely, you can see it's got three tails, and you can also see those gills moving on its back. So this tells us that this mayfly nymph needs nice, clean, well-oxygenated water in which to breathe. So this is a good sign, if we see one of these, that we've got a nice, healthy ecosystem. So there's another freshwater shrimp and another pair of freshwater shrimps just swimming by. Now, if we have a little look over here, there's a ram's horn snail just there in the middle. And then over here are the caddisfly, the cased caddisfly nymphs. And you can see that one there just coming out of its shell, out of its tube. You can see that it's stuck all of those pieces of gravel together to make this tube. And this creature has a hook. It has hooks on the end of its body, which help it to hold onto that tube, which it can then carry around. And you'll see there's a shrimp just having a little ride on its back. And in fact, we've also got another mayfly nymph. There it is. If we can zoom in there, that's another mayfly nymph, which is a different species. So this is an olive, a type of olive. And again, it can be identified with three tails in the same way that we identify the other mayflies. So there's the much larger one over there. So some nice, interesting creatures that you'll find living in this lovely chalk stream.